Yeah, see, Maharaj, oh, I love it. Maharaj.
Yeah, I got my three pals with me.
Oh, namaste, namaste, namaste.
The three that my three. Whatever that is. The only. It's all the only. Same, looking through all these eyes, your eyes, everything. Cats, dogs, monkeys, elephants, ants, mosquitoes, snakes. Same. That's all names. Well, greetings and welcome. I really, I have a bit to say, and I really welcome with my heart, because I know what it's like to be confused, you know. But it's, you know, maybe we can get somewhere today, which is nowhere. Well, yeah, I have a few things to read, and say. Right now, we're all not in a world the way you think of a world as a physical world. We're in a frequency. This is a frequency. We don't know what that is. No one does. But it's not a world. It's a holographic, holonomic flow frequency. There's only one here called Brahman. That's a name. We don't know what that is. Everyone says Brahman. That's another name because we name it. Brahman, God. No one knows what God is. Everyone's trying to know it. You're the knower. And you don't know who that is. But you think you know who you are. Isn't that a hoot? Everybody has all this information that's erroneous. And if I say, who are you? Well, you know, okay. Who told you that? One thing I wanted to say is I always say there's no birth or death. There's a birth, but not the birth that you think of a birth or we were taught as a birth. It's a spontaneous appearance in the frequency, made of nothing. So we were born as a holographic body-mind organism out of the five elements that's inhabited by this God force, this Vishnu, this whatever words you want to give to it. It's not different. I'm speaking to myself. Myself is listening. Each individual has their own tissues, but each individual has their own universal dream, private to them, but by the same one. So everyone here has their own individuated universal dream of life, and I'm included in it. You're included in mine. Same ones doing it. Okay? Yeah, a lot of Shakti here today, so you got to give me a little sway, okay? Might settle down. I don't know. It's up to her. You know? I don't have some other entity to quell that. It's her business, not mine. You know, I'm a field commander, so to speak, of hers. This energy, I call it hers because it's creative. We think of the female as the creative one, but there's no male, female, same one. Maharaj said, if you imagine yourself a man or a woman, it's kind of like a disease. And we see the results of it. Well, we're not going to talk about society, the madhouse. I want to focus on your personal, as universal, not you, forget the you you think you are. I'm saying your individuated seed form of this energy, projecting this life. You know, I want to focus on that. Everything else is crap. Forget the world. The world's in you. You're not in a world. Truly, the world's in you. I explained that a couple of times. So, I have something to read by the great Maharaj. That which spoke through him is speaking through me now. Reading what it said through him, see? Okay. He says, in reality, you are full of bliss. Pain has a cause, so does pleasure, fear, and worry. Only the bliss is causeless. It always was. I know. Think of that. What you are never had a beginning. Consider it. What you are never had a beginning. Always was. Now. Okay. Only the bliss is causeless, which you are yourself. This one I'm describing. The only one. I always say the only. While searching for pain and pleasure, while searching for pain and pleasure, the fear and worry were found. When through a myriad of influences, the identification with body, you're told you're so-and-so, you're a boy, you're a girl, you got to do this. The I am creates this impulse to do. What the mind does with that impulse is, that's where things go awry. But it's all just expansive entertainment and flowing back towards yourself. That's why you're here. So it while searching for pain and pleasure, this ideation, this egoic idea, me, which you didn't have until you were about 3 or 4, and you aren't physically born into a world, you're in a frequency, holographic frequency. About that age, this identity gets formed and it gets solidified. It's all bullshit. Not a bit of truth to it. There's no person. Oh, and I see, I act like one, right? No, this is how she acts. But it gets co-opted by this idea in the mind that keeps rambling on, I do it, he did it, this, that, nama rupa, nete nete, not this, not this, is the solution. Because it's all a lie. Not one thing you can say is true. Nothing. You can't tell me you know anything, because you don't. As long as the hubris of the ego insists that don't tell me, suit yourself. You will, until you don't. I promise you that. Some people just have a real propensity for suffering. They like it. It makes them comfortable in some odd, distorted way. It makes them feel safe. When they are safety, they're safe as mother's milk already. Because they wandered away, now they have to feel safe. Well, come back, repent, turn around, repent, turn around, come back, come back. Put your cell phone down. Stop looking around. Stop watching the bullshit world news. It's not there. You don't have time for that. I'm not going to get into that too much, but I will later. So, only bliss is causeless, which you are yourself. It is because you have not found, not realized yourself, not become yourself. The ego, of course, wants to become that. It still wants to do things. It wants to control the show. You are that. It is because you have not found, not realized yourself. Only the bliss is causeless, which you are yourself. You're just ignoring and being lazy and habituated, fearful. That's the ego. It's not you. It doesn't exist. I've already said, you tell me what it is and no one can. But then they kind of chuckle and go, that's really weird, man, and go right off doodly-dooing. I just showed you, you don't know shit. Yeah, I don't. Wow, that's really cool, man. Wow. It's like a sugar rush. Then you do nothing with it. Go right back to looking at all the bullshit. Like it has something to offer you. All you got is time. In the time we've been speaking right now, you're about, I don't know, 15 minutes closer to death. Bliss is your form. Bliss is your color. Bliss is your shape. Bliss is your nature. That's why it seems like I'm speaking like any other person. That's what is. What isn't is the ideas overlaid on top of it. That's why you don't become anything. You take the shit off. The unwanted stuffy stuff. And you find the real stuffy stuff. Revelation. For no one. Why no one? Because there's only one here. You can't even say that because it would have to be an other to say it, which is kind of the role we play in this dance. We are the divine manifesting to know itself, because without this manifestation of the human form with the intellect to negotiate what we're doing right now, it can't know of itself. That's why it does this. It's potentiality. It shines a light. We're in that light as a frequency. There's many frequencies. I've gone over that, you know. But you don't have to book a ticket. You want to book a ticket to this, what we call source, but there's no source because nothing ever left it. Only an ego would look for a source when it is a source and the expression. Bliss is your shape, bliss is your nature, only bliss is causeless, which you are yourself. I saw the first fall of snow, the very first fall. The one that's looking through these peepers and making this soundy sound was there. Because John's gone, he's been gone. Adios. Don't let the door hit you in the ass. So, With that said, this is Maharaj, I guess, at one of his satsangs, which he did so many. It's amazing. He says, okay. You are the only witness to your dream. The only. As I always call it, the only. My only and your only are the same only. There's no difference actually between anything you see. It's just waves of energy moving, dancing, vibrating. You are the only witness to your dream. Your universe is limited only to you. The guru's work is to free you from your concepts. Guru's grace is needed to know that you are not the body. That's what's happening here. It is just like you are not the clothes that you wear. The mantra Mulam Guru Vakyam means, as the guru says, I am pure Brahman. Nothing else. No one knows what Brahman is. That's a word. You know nothing. You are everything, but you know nothing. You're nothingness and you're everythingness. Once you're that, you have no questions. They're already answered. Only an ego has questions. Our true nature never changes. The more you know it, the more your desires and cravings will vanish. So the more you attend, the more you give your spare time to what's being said and what I'm saying and he said and all in one said, you will know what it is you're asking for. But instead, you must give something. Everything has a price in this frequency. The price for knowing yourself is your time. Don't piss it away. Maharaj, upon hearing this from his guru, believed him and spent all his spare time sitting in silence, not looking at an iPhone, not texting, not talking, not thinking. And he got there real quick. Now your mind says, oh, this is going to take forever. That's all bullshit. You're that. How forever can it take to know what you are? Use ichi, use will. Oh, I heard I don't have free will. You don't have any will. But consciousness does. That's what will is. Brahman has all the will you can. If you had faith, you can move mountains in Brahman. The problem with a lot of the things that are said in satsang is it gets filtered through this ego, so it comes to conclusions. He says, oh, it's all destined. Everything that happens is destined. That's bullshit. There's plenty of will. It's just not yours. The first thing you got to do is come back, repent, turn around. Ramana said, go back the way you came. Sit still, be still and know. Then all old things become new again, said Christ. First you will be filled with wonder. Then you will know and you will be able to, then that will becomes your will as that. You follow? I hope. All Our true nature never changes. The more you know it, the more your desires and cravings will vanish. So it reaps immediate benefit to sit and be still. The ego calls it a task and says, oh shit, I don't want to do that. Don't listen to that. The mind will lie to you every time. The more you know, the more desires and cravings will vanish. As the self is free of desires, your cravings cannot remain. The self has no cravings for anything. It's totally full. You won't become a bump on the log because Chitti is going to keep doing and maintaining this body and taking care of this body, giving it food and shelter, because it wants to do this because it's doing this to know itself as its cohort, the active and the one looking. Same. Right? As individual souls, human beings love their bodies. Even after the beginning of the love for self, the body is taken care of spontaneously. Remember this. One of the first things I hear from people, well, how will anything get done? And I say, well, how do you digest your food? If you cut your hand, how do you make it heal? You do that? Oh, nature does that. Where does nature end and you begin? At what point do you take over the task of nature? And then when nature imposes, you go, oh, can't fight Mother Nature. I mean, all this dopey shit. It's so dopey when you see it. But I don't feel bad. You know, I know it. That's why I really know how you feel. I can't remember how I felt anymore, but I know that it was confusing. I honestly cannot recall in a tactile, sensorial manner what it was like to be a people. It's been too many years. I don't even, it's like that's before I was born. I have memories of events, but I don't know how it felt. I can't retrieve that feeling. When people say, do this as a people, I don't know who to summon to do that people stuff anymore. Just snatch. I don't know where I could find it. It was just an imagination. Yeah? Guru mantra or guru's words describe our true nature, which we can realize. Don't tell me, oh, if it's destined, throw that out. You have the free will of ichi, and you can use it even as an ego just by saying, talk to yourself in your private moments and don't go on about how you feel bad and all this shit. Just say, I want to know. And be still. Talk to yourself, because that's consciousness talking to itself. You do it all the time anyway, thinking. Don't be embarrassed to actually be open and honest. In your private, at 2 a.m. when the world is still, because everyone's in sleep state, and the spacey space is not active with talky talk. That's why in the wee hours, it's so more accessible. I used to wake up at 3 a.m. Now I just sleep in 2.5 hour increments. It's just one long day now. Day, night, same thing. Now. But that's, you know, oh, this rigid scheduling that society says, oh, you have to have this at a certain time. That creates the whole idea that there's time, first of all. But you can play with that. When I was working, I got up for years. I would get up at 4 a.m. and meditate silently for 2 hours, go to work, come home, another 2 hours, eat, then sit and read and sit. No TV. Why would you watch that? Why would you watch other people who are deluded for entertainment? When you want to know yourself, you don't want to know how, you want to, don't want to be entertained by fools. And I'm not saying, okay, I can call Brahman a fool when Brahman's being a fool and not feel bad about it. Only people are politically correct, not Brahman. After self-realization, there will be no need to desire anything. It'll all come to you. Without worry, without mulling, if ye have faith, you can move mountains, and mountains will come to you. You won't even have to go get them. Whatever portion is needed, it'll come. I'm living proof. I'm apparent living proof. I'm an appearance in a holonomic frequency that's proof. Your body was neither created by your parents nor by God. It developed spontaneously in this frequency. As compared to yourself, all the pilgrim centers of the world are so small. These places of Ramana's mountain and everything. They're small. These places have gathered importance in your own light. You're the light of consciousness and prior to it. There's two lights. There's a second light. Never doubt the self or your guru. It is the greatest sin. A sin is amiss. It's not being a bad people. It's just missing the point. It's like repent isn't saying I'm sorry. It's just turning around. Don't bother with the apologies. That's religious, you know, dogma. Have you ever thought of taking help of your own light? I just said, speak to your own light. Don't be shy. But don't ramble on about what you want. Oh my God. You want to know the light. Please, and be earnest. Don't be embarrassed. Be earnest. Don't bullshit God, yourself, whatever word you want. And watch what happens. Open up, surrender, accept all the words you've heard. Now you know what to do with them. Have you ever thought of taking help of your own light? The outer light is only an expression of your inner light. I've been saying for years, the sun is the same light. It's just a reflection of the inner light. The sky, it looks really big. You should see the inner sky. It's endless. The universe isn't endless. It's tiny. One of the first things I said upon awakening is in the second week, I wandered out, it was a full moon. I was with my wife then, and I told her all this could easily be on the tip of a pin. All of it. That's how big I felt even then. Before I still had to go through all these, it was okay, but it was instantaneously seen. That's for me, I don't know. This is all different, but The outer light is an expression of your inner light. Your body is of a human, but your consciousness is the same as all living beings. So it looks like we have different shapes and forms and imprints, personalities, which are imprinted and coded. But it belongs to the same one. So Muktananda said to Guru Mahi, when she was realized, but just still ripening, she complained about the Westerners coming to the ashram in India because they were different and they were kind of dopey. She said, you know, the British came for a little tea and never left. And he stopped and says, there's still people you don't like? There's still people you don't like? That means you don't like yourself. There's broken ones. There's ones that need a good smack in the head, but you don't mistake it. And certainly don't go around saying, I like this and I don't like that. Self doesn't do that. Chitti can wield a sword, but she knows who's wielding it and who's receiving it. The ego says, I don't like that one. It's all about, it's nonsense. Leads to war. And it's empty. It's just a dream of war. Fictional. So your body is of a human, but your consciousness is the same as all living beings. It is not different in a human body, although the human intellect is not present in other beings. The body is alive due to the self. Due to your body identity, you take yourself to be someone. There are no someones. And afterwards you can play in that and not get caught in it. As I say, when you know what you are, now you can fully be what you are and interact without any entrapment. Joyously, freely, honestly. Due to your body identity, you take yourself to be someone. That will go with your true knowledge as the self. You won't be a someone anymore. That'll go. The end of your body is certain, but with what identity would you like to die? It's common. It's transitional. You can die and suffer a scary death. Know yourself and see it as transition and it's liberation. So for some, it's absolute fear. For others, it's joy and liberation. No resistance. Whenever it comes. Short, long, doesn't matter. The end of your body is certain, but with what identity would you like to die? Light of the sun and moon is nothing as compared to that of the self. It's reflected. But it's the same light. You want to see the light of the self? Look at the sun. It's a reflection of that. It's not the sun. It's an appearance of the sun in a hologram reflected from the inner light. What I call the astral globe, where all this, it's just imagination of God. We don't know what it is, but you're that. And knowing that, you're fine. There's no separate one saying, I want to know anymore, because you know directly. The silence of fullness, eternal life, and bliss. As long as, the bliss will go as soon as you're in the absolute. The bliss is only during the manifestation. You don't go on in eternal bliss. You're the self. When it expresses, it feels blissful. Do you have bliss in deep sleep? No. But sleep is bliss in that you don't need anything. That's bliss. It's not ecstasy. There are ecstasies whilst in the waking state and whilst embodied in knowing self, which it enjoys, not you. Okay? But the true bliss is needing nothing. It's the perfect state. But it does this to know itself, and it takes care of the body, and the ego complains about it. But the body has to, it keeps on going, regardless of what the ego says. Unless sometimes the ego gets so bent out of shape, it kills the body. Out of frustration. Unnecessary. Your true self is not frustrated. It's reveling. It's reveling in itself, saying, and part of the revelation, that the end of the line is going, is this discovery that I'm talking about. When it discovers itself, there's no enlightenment. Whoa. No such thing. It's the worst word I ever heard. At best, it's revelation to the self, of the self. Self-deluded, self not deluded. Enlightenment, everyone, that is such, you don't want to be enlightened because you can't. Enlightenment means you're death while you're alive. Are you willing to die? Now, and be free, but then you can't be free because there's no freedom in this, because who would have it? I don't have freedom nor bondage. I'm beyond both. Only an ego can imagine itself free or bound. You hear people say, I'm freedom itself. Well, you're not done yet. You're not fully cooked yet. Then you got the Sadguru saying, you can be a billionaire. Don't listen to that jackass. That grifter. With dull eyes but a hard stare. False prophet. Bullshit artist. Making money. Lying. Oh, but he doesn't know. I don't. He can't know. If you knew, he wouldn't do that. And enough of him. Meditate on your consciousness. It is easier for one who is disgusted with all other activities when you finally had it. Your consciousness is moving not just one, but innumerable bodies all at the same time. And the atoms and the electrons going around and the blood and the cells and the digestion and the synapses and the lightning all at the same time. You're not impressed? We split it up with Manas saying, that's lightning, that's thunder, it's all nature, but I'm not nature. I'm trying to control nature. I'm very frustrated with it. I'm afraid of it. And it's a hologram. is, but it's neither real nor unreal. It is, but it's not physical like we think at all. It's energy, vibration, and frequency. Excuse me. In light, we don't know what light is. No one here can tell me what light is. It's a word or a percept. Photon, Motown, go ahead, knock yourself out. If you're honest with yourself, you go, holy shit, I don't know what anything is. Then you're on your way. As long as you're saying as long as you're keeping a little thing over here that you know, a little comparative dance that you like to do, when you don't know who that is that likes to do it either, you're just being dishonest to yourself. And still saying, I want to know yourself, myself. How silly is that? The price is simple, your time. You piss away most of it anyway. Texting people you don't really like about shit you don't really care about. And it's all unreal. You don't see people in ashrams with their... Oh, hold on, I got a text. What were you saying about God? You don't see that. You might today. That would be a horror, but I can't imagine it. And you don't see anyone sitting in an ashram reading a newspaper. Reading lies, looking for truth. The media is poison. You're poisoning your brain. Everyone's an addict now. In the Kali Yuga. It's unreal. I was in a studio, the engineer is so addicted, he's 33, ripe for the addiction. Rolling, I'm doing a vocal, he's texting. Would he do that with Bob Dylan? He wouldn't even be allowed to bring the phone in the room. First of all, he wouldn't work with anyone like that. Not to be comparative, but I'm just making a point. That's how addictive. The whole world are junkies, the media. This war in Ukraine is now the entertainment on the media. Have you noticed? And everyone feigns, oh, I care. You don't care. You care just so much. But you can't stop looking at it. Some part is entertained by that shit, all that suffering, which is born out of this dystopic dance. You don't have to be like the rest of the world. You can take a stand. It's in your power. How much do you want to know? How much do you want to use this dream for why you're dreaming it as Brahman, not as who you say you are? You're ignoring the impulse of Brahman and being co-opted, and then you're saying, how do I do it? Because I'm done. But you won't let go of the one that's unreal. You won't examine it. You won't give yourself the time. You won't give your own heart the time. You will be rewarded beyond measure. I promise you. He says here, be aware of the fact that all this is your own information. Everything I'm saying is true to you right now. Then your worth will not be less than that of Brahman. Think it's worth it? A little bit of time? I don't know. I'm really busy. Says nobody. Most of your actions are out of your imagination. Now you have heard that you are Brahman. Put it into practice, he says. Show you mean it. Stop saying I can't when you don't know who's saying it. Or I'm not ready. It's not destined. Forget that. Whereas your body identification leads you to your death, your staying as Brahman saves you. The time dissolves in you because then, once you know Brahman, I don't go into deep sleep goes into me, okay? Then time dissolves into you. And not you in time. Because there is no time, is now. Yes, the past is a memory in the now, and the future is a projection in the now. Ourself is the same as Guru Deva. Now, only the mind gets purified of its illusions and delusions. You're not the mind, you're Brahman. Let it be. Don't be recalcitrant. That one doesn't exist. Ourself is the same as Guru Deva. That is the only place to surrender. There is no other place to surrender to, and it's right here. Just a little time. No pride. Ego's all pride, hubris. Pride is the most futile feeling to have because it belongs to a ghost. You are a ghost appearance, but it belongs to a secondhand ideation, imagination. True knowledge is the great weapon of Brahma, and it is invincible. Nothing can harm it. There goes the fear. No mas fear. Why would you be afraid of yourself when you're eternal? You celebrate that. That's what's happening here. It's been hijacked. The sage looks like others, but in reality, he is indescribable. I couldn't describe myself. Struggling here. When you really know him, you become like him, capital H. Meditate on the meditator. This way. Don't think about it. B. Yoga. Forget all this stuffy stuff. The mind loves to dance in the stuffy stuff, name, form, I like, I don't like. Forget it. Meditate on the meditator, not on anything else. Don't do any kind of imagination dreamies and meditation crap. Unnecessary. One should be fortunate to be able to hear self-knowledge explained in this manner. I agree, Maharaj. Kudos to Brahma through Maharaj saying that so clearly. Kudos to Brahman here listening so earnestly. I can see it. Yeah? Chitty's doing that. This is Chitty, made of Chitty, playing with its creation, holographic, enjoying it. No people. Energy, vibration, and frequency. And the only. Do that. Nothing else. There's one here being entertained by this. Only one. Looks like more than one. Not even the stuffy stuff. How's that moving anyway? We don't know. We don't know what it is. Oh, it's metal. What's that? Well, it's an ore. What's an ore? Well, it's stuff in the earth. What's that? Well, it's atoms. What's that? We don't know. Bodhidharma, who's before me? No knowing. Vast emptiness. No beginning, no end. No holiness, because where is the other to be holy about what? It is divine. I like to use that word because you make this. Well, it's doing it. You're a part of it. But this is amazing. There's no such thing as mundane. Well, I have to take care of my body. No, you don't. Chitty's doing it. You imagine a someone who does the things that she does. She being the only creative energy here. Chitta. That's a name. We don't know who she is. We don't know from whence, how. None of that's known. We see function. Once one is in this place, you're informed. You'll never know. It's not an object. It can't be known. And it's not talking, but it'll inform, embrace, and fill, overspilling. Nothing can harm you. Nothing can harm anybody, whether they know it or not. It's just imagination. You're safe as mother's milk. See? Endless fun. You'll never be bored. Ever. Okay. All right. Around. Hey, Hendrik. Raul. Muhammad, Susan, Michael. You're all Brahman. Different names and shapes and memory. But the Brahman has the memory, the spacey space, not you. You're an imagination. Let it go. You'll be all right. Hi, Ellen. James. Jay. Gosh. Oh, Mohan, I already said hi to you. Elizabeth. My dear. Brahman. Now. Don't tell me you don't know it. That one doesn't know what he's talking about. You won't know it. You'll be it. You are it. It can't be known. That's the problem. You're looking for it. You look. Ego says, I'll do this. And very subtle levels, I'll manage this, then awakening, I'll take care of it. It still sticks around. Just be on point. Notice, gently. Don't battle. A thought, which is an ego, should not battle other thoughts. That's a dog chasing its tail. Just notice and smile. Notice when you're being tugged out of being into thinking, doing, comparing, but notice gently and just have an inner smile, grin, and say, oh. Certainly don't say I screwed up again, because now you're back in that loop. The I is a thought saying I screwed up again. And then that feeling comes over the body and you feel like crap. The emotions make for unpleasantness. All right. I think that was enough. At least a happy meal. A very happy meal. So digest it well. And I'll see you all on the flippity flop. Forget the fear and loathing in Camp Wonderland. It's nonsense. Just stay in Camp Wonderland by itself. Okay. All right. I'm gonna roll.
Thank you, NGG. Thank you.
It's been good to see you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All the best.
Thank you, John.
Arayam Tat Sat.